Was the day that the Lord released His grace on what? On 120 people. and you operate with it.
Now, if God still does the same, it means that for every time that we gather, as a Christian body within the fold of Christ, it means that there must be an increase of at least 120 amongst us in the Spirit of God. Now, do you still see that? Now, if you don't see that, we need to understand that, you see, the ethics is still there. The debt is still there. The power is still there. The reasoning behind that is still there. When you don't think it's perfected. But why are we not seeing the efficacy in our individual life and in the life of the body of Christ? We'll get to that in a minute. When you read the first lesson of today, where he ended is right, where I believe he should have started. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You know, when you go down from verse 16, it talks about the Lord saying to Moses, gather 70 elders of Israel for me, so I can do what? So I can release my spirit upon them. But the lesson, that's what we have to use. But we have to do what? Take some of that and take from verse 16 and look at the second lesson and look at it in the spirit of Pentecost. We do everything within 45 minutes. Praise the Lord. Let's tell everybody be attentive in the spirit. Not just in the body. Because you can hear by the body. If your spirit man is not there, you cannot understand everything that you said. They will just ask you, what did they say? You say, because you're not there. Praise the Lord. Now, but when you look, there's something we need to draw out from the first lesson. When you read the first part of the first lesson, it talks about complaining. It talks about what?
Complaining.
And it said the Lord was angry. Now, ask yourself this question. If the Lord can be angry against his people that are complaining, it means that for every time that he complains in this church, God is angry with you. Hello? Do you understand what I'm just saying?
Yes.
What does the Bible say to us? First lesson.
When
they did what?
When
they complained,
it displeased the Lord.
It displeased the Lord.
And the Lord heard it.
And the Lord heard it.
And his anger was kindled.
And his anger, not the anger of the elders, not the anger of the service conductor, not the anger of the pastor, not the anger of the chairman or the prophet leader, but the Lord heard it. And the anger of God was kindled against them. Yes? Hallelujah. Listen, may the fire of the Lord not burn
among
them. Something that we are not aware of. We are bound to do it. And it brings about punishment and what? And tribulation in our lives. Just look at the week gone. Or no, don't look at the week gone. Just look at last Sunday alone. How many mothers complain here? How many fathers complain there? Now, the Bible is telling you that, listen, God listens to prayer. He does not hear you when you start to complain, period. He does not what? This is not the lesson I was supposed to read today. But if I come to you today and I'm listening to the lesson, you tell them that you're going to have strange doctrine. That's what I'm reading that to you. This has been written since last year from KC. But what I'm saying is that things that we don't know, it puts us in the firing line of God. And when you put, when you let goes out from God, who is that person that's going to retract it? No one. All they did was that they complained. But they forgot it. When they left Egypt, they got to the Red Sea. Most of what we're going to do is stretch the rod, they went past. There was no water, they drank. There was no food, they had manna. And all these things, when they ask God, ask yourself this question, how many times have you asked God something and the Lord has not answered you? And after that, how many times have you not asked?
There's no power in this church again. That's the pastor. Like, we don't even know. Maybe he's, maybe he's not, not that good. He's not more experienced. He's not like before. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
The Bible tells you that the fire of the Lord was released. Not his fire. They were complaining to Moses, but God heard it. Now, what I love most is verse 3 and 4. What does verse 3 and 4 say?
And he called the name of the place, Haberah. Because the fire of the Lord
was kindled against him. Yes, carry on.
And the mixed multitude.
Thank you very much. Do you know who are the mixed multitudes? When you read the Yoruba version, it's so very explicit. Very explicit. It is better that you comprehend the meaning of that word.
Awa.
adalu opo eniyan.
Awon ni.
Awon adalu opo eniyan.
They were not part of the original plan. But in the way somewhere just mixed. That's what you see in Celestial Church today. You now kneel down before a prophet, they ask you to go and bring the goods. They're not part of the original plan. Those are the people that are mentioned in this book. Now, let's cast our mind back to the inception of let's move away from Celestial War. Let's look at the church that we worship now. It's when it started, 1993, October. There are some people that were there that these are the things that we stand for. These are the things that we are going to do. This is where they were going to be. But along the line, some mixed ones came in. And because maybe of their strength, of their vocal power, or how they can convince people, they now say, no, that's okay. We don't need to do that again. And let's do this. And those are the ones that bring trouble. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
But you see, I love God so much. God always gives them the opportunity to do it. Do you know Mephibosheth?
Yes.
You know him?
Yes.
Whose son was he?
Jonathan.
He was even far away. When the Lord was ready, he brought him back. Because he was in the wrong place at that time. And if he was there at that time, where Jonathan was there, they would have failed his purpose would not have been fulfilled. And when you look at another son of David, Absalom is one of the greatest orators. He always sits and at the part of the king, his father. When people came in, when he speaks to them, they sit down and they listen. So he starts to win their souls. So he said, he got to a point, he said, you know what? David does not know how to do anything. Let's do this video. Let's make him. Praise the Lord. What happened to him? He killed himself. Ask yourself, as you're sitting down, are you a member of this church or are you a mixed multitude? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You see, the mixed multitude are the ones that complains. Because they've been to our pastor Adimaya's church. They've been to Pastor Adimaya's church. That one will jump up, put his leg down, use whatever they want to use. And you see, what we Christians are looking for now, we are not looking for the demonstration of the Holy Spirit, we are looking for the demonstration of the removal of the issues of our life. And as long as you go there, they told you, this is what is your, they pray for you. Whatever they use, you care less to do. As long as you get to God. But where are you going? Then you now come back to church. On what? On Sunday. I went somewhere last week. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That man was fire. He was fire. And if you're not careful, they will do it. The time you get to fire you. And when they fire you, what upsets me most that is when they go into the firing line, we don't know about it. But when they got fired, they got fired and come here. Then they don't come and I come. We will not know where they got that issue from. We will not know that. Hallelujah. That type of prayer I don't do. Anything is wrong with you, we pray together. I'll be around that when I come back. But daddy, this one came to you, what is wrong with him or her? You see, there are some people, when you read the book of Joshua, chapter number 7, where Achan was punished, the Lord said, the Lord was angry with Achan, angry with his family, angry with his goats. Tell me, what was the problem with goats? Was the goat the one that went to steal? That is that sometimes when you move with some people that the Lord is angry with, the Lord is angry with you. I will explain you about it. I thought it would be good because the Lord was crazy. Then you have that thing that you do and this is busy. All unbelief. So technically, taking the Bible to again, all unbelief is you. And that's why it's always good for us. So when you come, you always want, we need to do it now. When, before, keep it to die in here. But again, another one. It first goes into the soul of your body. You start to water it every single day. It is when you grow, when you start to bear fruits, it is when we know about it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And that's why it's so very good for us prophets. We're going to it now. The day of Pentecost.
There's a key there. And the key is the only thing that is going to work. Nothing else will work. And that key, when you read the book of Acts of Apostles chapter number 2, it told us the adjective there, the operating one there, yes?
And when the day of Pentecost was fully come,
yes?
They were all with one accord.
Thank you very much. That's all you need. When there's no accord, you see, when the Lord comes to okay, let me tell you this question. As the Lord comes to this service today now, you'll be looking, maybe after a while, you have a woman's prayer, one woman will not stand at the front, you have to pray. Jehovah Jesus Christ bless her children. And one person will be looking at the person behind. What type of prayer do you really have to do? Come on, I can pray what I need. You are not in accordance. That prayer can never be answered. And that's why the spirit of Pentecost is not visiting us as before. Because the operating word, they were there in one account. They were waiting for the Holy Spirit that Jesus has promised. And they know that once Jesus has promised it, he's bound to do what? He's bound to come to pass. And that's why we do prayer service now also many times. We drink a lot. The week I'm going to beat us, I think we stole it. You drink seawater, drink every single thing. By the time you get it, now I'm masquerading, it is you. It's because your mind is not there. If your mind is not there, your body is there. You see, go to the book of Genesis chapter number 1, verse number 27. Let me explain to you. Genesis 1, verse 7.
So God created man in his own image.
God created man in his own image, yes?
In the image
of God he created him, yes?
Male and female created he them. And God blessed them.
Yes.
And God said unto them,
Be
fruitful and multiply.
Yes.
And replenish the earth.
Thank you very much. You see, the Lord created them. He told them to be fruitful and multiply. But the authority and the mandate of God is not in their life. It wasn't there then. And that's why when you go to the same book of Genesis chapter number 2, when you read verse number 7, you will see the release of the Spirit of God into the life of man, yes?
And God formed man.
And now listen, if God has created him first, he's not forming him now. That means he's making it complete. Yes?
And the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground.
Yes.
And breathed into his nostrils.
And the breath into his nostrils.
And the breath of life.
The breath of life, praise the Lord. You see, that breath of life is the Spirit of God. Every single one of us has the Spirit of God in us. But they are not operating in one single form. They are operating in diversity. That's why when you read the Ephesians chapter number 4, it tells you that in the diversity of the spirits. It tells you that some he gave as prophet, some he gave as apostle, some he gave as pastor, some he gave as evangelist, some he gave as teacher, and some as prophet. He is 2-3-5 different areas, but all three were one spirit. But what I'm going to talk about today is what? There's the one that the Lord has given to us as prophets and as prophetesses. The English Bible defines prophecy as a prophet as someone that the Lord has sent on a specific message. A specific message what? To man for the edification of the church. Any message that is being released is not for the edification of the church. That message is not from God. Well, let me rephrase it. If you watch it in the church, that from the head to the bottom, we all confess Christ. And you're not given a message that is not edifying that church, that message is not from God. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
If any phone, holy shot, I go to and now you're in the wrong place. It is what? For the edification of the church, so that the church can grow. In that church that you are, there's a woman that I used to see. And what I love so much about Satan, he will give you a description. Full one. So much that you will not miss that person that they are describing. But is that edifying the church of God? Grandma told us that if one of us is found in one iniquity, the rest of us should do what? Should bring that person into place by the authority of Christ. As a prophet, the Lord has released his authority in us. When you go to the book of Genesis chapter number 1, when you read verse 1, it says, in the beginning, the Lord created the heaven and earth. And the earth was that form and void. And darkness was over it. And the Spirit of the Lord was over it. Out of that spirit, the Lord spoke light into that darkness. So it means that even if there is darkness there, by the Spirit of God that is released to you, you must be able to speak light. If you are not supposed to be, you are not supposed to be arrogating the spirit of darkness.
said what? Let there be light, and there was light. And there was chaos. Nothing was arranged. Okay, water, move away. Let's see the ground. That is the sole duty of us, what? Prophets and prophetess. And when you even look at the Greek translation of it, it calls it prophetess. You remove the men out. You leave the women in. Now, that is the job of a prophet. And today is the day of the celebration of the release of the Holy Spirit of God into prophets and prophetesses. Where are you and where are you not partaking in it? All we see is a demonstration of shouts. Hey, But when you read that Act of Apostles chapter number 2 again, it told us that they were giving utterance, and so they were speaking as the Spirit gave them utterance. For those of us that joined Celestia in Nigeria, when you are in service, you will not hear three or four prophets pronouncing the same thing. But here, it is A-L-I-A. Another one will say the same thing. At the back there, even in the changing room upstairs, another person will do what? Say the same thing. Is that the same utterance that we are giving here? Acts 2. What does it say? Yes? Yes? And he sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. And began to speak in other tongues. As the Spirit gave them utterance. God is a God of diversity. If God is not the God of diversity, the world will just be one language. And it will not give it. When you read the prophet, when you read the commentary, he said they heard the Greek speaking in Jew. They heard Hausa, Congo, and Igbo. But here now, every single thing, I want to prophesy like Holy Language. It should not be. It should not be at all. You must speak as the Spirit has given you utterance. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You should do what? You should speak. Now, because that Spirit that the Lord has given to you, Jesus said to the disciples, he said, I'm coming to the 120 that was given, there was a release of power. He sent the 70 out. He said, go out, heal the sick. Speak to the devil in my name. After that 17, when you go to the book of Numbers, chapter number 25, you will see there, it talks about numbers of 50. 50 means jubilee. It means what? Release. It means freedom. So that means that when you have the 50 to the 17, it becomes around 20 that the Lord gave the power to on what? On that Pentecost day. When you look at the ether of the 50, the 50 was supposed to make man to be free. So the Holy Spirit that's released is supposed to give freedom to you, supposed to give freedom to you, freedom to you, freedom to you, and freedom to me. But are we using that freedom now to do what? To incarcerate ourselves? Because the reason why the Holy Spirit is given is for us to see the minds of God. It means that the minds of God, and God has told us in Genesis 1:28 that His mind for us is for us to dominate. It means that when we are working in a way, in an area that we are not dominating, and the things are dominating us, the mind of God will tell us, my son, don't go that way, that is the way that you need to go. To give us freedom.